Good morning, students. This is the fourth video of the chapter Nazism and the Rise of Hitler. And this video has been made for class 9. So, in this particular video, we'll discuss that how the circumstances led to the emergence of Hitler as a powerful leader in Germany. We need to understand here that when Weimar Republic came, it became the most powerful body in Germany after World War I. But it earned criticism as well as anger of the public because it signed Treaty of Versailles that was considered a humiliating treaty among the German people. Now we are going to discuss that ultimately what the problem occurred in Germany that led to the emergence of Hitler. So we need to understand here that Weimar Republic, it became weak over the time. Why? Because it was having some internal defects. Despite the fact Weimar Republic was the government after World War I, it was having many defects also. And particularly, the defect was mentioned under Article number 48. So, what was there in the Article number 48? It was mentioned in the Article number 48 that it was mentioned very clearly under 48 that President may declare emergency. It can declare any fundamental right as illegal, or it can clearly nullify any fundamental rights or civil rights. So, this was completely a dictator law that was not acceptable in a democratic country. So, this is why the people started hating the Weimar Republic, because it was not a completely democratic body and it gave enormous power to the president to suspend even the fundamental rights or civil rights of the ordinary people. Now, that was the situation. So, ultimately found that because of the Weimar Republic, or as the Weimar Republic was present, the German faced many problems like economic crisis, political crisis, as well as much harassment, much humiliation. So, as a result, ultimately people started hating the Weimar Republic. And meanwhile, Hitler got the chance to emerge as an important leader in Germany. So, let us go with the Hitler. Hitler rise to power. So, how Hitler came to power? We need to understand. But first of all, we have to go through his life history. He was a very poor man. He was a very poor person. He born in a poor family. And after that, he was recruited as a soldier in Germany. And he participated in the First World War, in which he got injured. So, when he was lying in the hospital, he heard the news that now Weimar Republic came to power and it signed a Versailles Treaty. And as per that treaty, Germany lost most of its territory. So that was very painful for a soldier like Hitler, because Hitler fought for each and every inch of the land. And now after the war, the Weimar Republic gave enormous piece of land to different countries. So it was very painful for a soldier who got injured, because he was fighting for protecting each and every piece of land. So that was very painful. So basically Hitler was a very poor person, and he came to power not very all of a sudden, but he emerged as a soldier. After that, he got many bravery awards in the army, and finally he got recognized in his own army. But as the World War started, he got injured. Finally, he was in the hospital when he saw the activities of Weimar Republic. Now, after the end of the World War, and when the peace treaty was signed, he came later on and moved towards different parts of Germany, and finally he formed a German Workers Party in 1919. So, German Workers Party was formed by Hitler in 1919, and later on it was renamed as Nazi Party by Hitler, and Hitler became the leader of that particular party. So, we saw that here the Hitler was a soldier and he developed himself as a political leader. So here we saw that Nazi party was formed in which the leadership was given to Hitler. In fact, Hitler himself organized this party, so that is why it is named there. Now, initially when this party participated in the election, it could not get much support of the ordinary public. But as the Weimar Republic was losing the support, and on the other hand, the other political parties were getting the support, so this is how the Hitler party, Nazi party also got support of ordinary people. So by 1932, Nazi became most famous party and it became also the largest party in that particular region by getting more than 37% of vote. So this is how we saw that Hitler Nazi party became the most important and the largest party in Russia. So that was the biggest achievement for Hitler, because Hitler started his career as a mere soldier, as an ordinary soldier, and later on he moved himself as an important political leader. Now, what was the qualities? How he became very popular? Several important traits or leadership qualities were there. And like Hitler was a great orator, he was a very good speaker as well as a very good leader. He was very knowledgeable and he was knowing the trick how to attract the ordinary men towards him, towards his thoughts, towards his ideologies. So Hitler was a powerful speaker. He was almost using all his words to catch the attention of the followers as well as the spectators. Now, apart from that, we need to understand it that when Hitler came to power, he became the political leader. He promised to his countrymen that he will restore the dignity that was lost because of the Treaty of Versailles. Because we already discussed that Weimar Republic signed Treaty of Versailles, and it took to almost accepted all the compensation, and ultimately Germany lost most of the things, including resources and territory. So he found that it was very humiliating. So basically, when Hitler came to power, he told clearly, he promised to his countrymen that he will restore the dignity that was lost because of the Versailles Treaty. Moreover, he also saw when he came to power that the country was facing much trouble because unemployment was there, poverty was there, lack of industrialization was moving in a negative way, or it was declining. So at the time, the Hitler promised to his countrymen that he will restore the industrialization, he will bring employment for the youth, and he will perform many good things. He will bring many good things for the upliftment of the different segment of society. But actually, all these things, that he promised, was in fact not true. Whatever he promised was meant for only particular segment of society. So we'll discuss later on that he identified or he demarcated the entire society into two different groups. One was superior in class and other was termed as inferior in class or in blood. So we'll discuss that. That was done by Napoleon. That was done by Sir Hitler, and Hitler was the man who moved ahead with the racial discrimination. So racial discrimination was performed by Hitler, and this is how Hitler earned name as well as he became very famous as well as he became notorious also. So over the time, because of his policies. So far what we discussed here that Weimar Republic came to power, but Weimar Republic could not become much popular, or it lost its popularity among the ordinary people because of its inherent defects or because of its wrong policies. Later on, Hitler came to power, but it was very slow process. First, he immersed himself as an important leader, small leader. First of all, he formed a party, German Workers' Party, became a member of that, and after that, he formed his own party. Later on, he became, by 1932, he became the most important leader, and his party became the largest party. And finally, he came forward, but it was not very easy task, because even at that time, Weimar Republic was there and it was a democratic country at that time. And Hitler was, you can say, he was still, although he formed a party, he was still a dictator type person. So it was very difficult even at that time. So finally, it was very difficult to challenge the Weimar Republic or wipe out the Weimar Republic. But Hitler ultimately did it, and he wiped out the Weimar Republic and finally established his dictatorship in Germany. And of course, the soldiers, and after that what he launched was known to world. Whatever he adopted as a policy was known to the world. So we'll discuss all this and we'll discuss about the Hitler and his programs in the upcoming videos. So this is all about this video. Thank you so much.